It has been a year since Metropolitan Epiphanius was elected the primate of the Orthodox Church of Ukraine. He visits retirement homes, supports relatives of captured Ukrainians, and helps seriously ill children. 15,000 people follow him on Instagram. Introducing the church to young people is one of the Metropolitan's key priorities. The transition of the Orthodox Church of Ukraine to the traditions of the Ecumenical Patriarchate is another of his strategic aims. For the first time, St. Michael's Golden Dome Cathedral started conducting services in sign language. There are also plans to introduce changes to the calendar of religious holidays.
We are not opposed to changing the date of the celebration of the Nativity of Christ, because this is not a matter of dogma. But at present, we see that not everyone supports this idea, especially in the Western region. Therefore, we'll continue to increase awareness, and when we see that the vast majority of Orthodox Christians are ready to change the calendar, we will implement a calendar reform.
The Orthodox Church of Ukraine was created at a unification council on December 15, 2018. It gathered representatives of the Ukrainian Autocephalous Orthodox Church and the Ukrainian Orthodox Church at the Kiev Patriarchate. Several senior clergymen of the Moscow Patriarchate joined the newly unified church as well. The transition of parishes to the Orthodox Church of Ukraine is ongoing. Over the past year, it was joined by almost 600 parishes of the Russian Orthodox Church of Ukraine. This is the new name of the Moscow Patriarchate in Ukraine as required by law.
The Moscow Patriarchate is trying by all means to suspend the process, which has taken place throughout the year. We even saw some officials prosecuting a public registrar. I think that in the future this matter will be settled, and hundreds or maybe even thousands of parishes that have not yet decided to join the Orthodox Church of Ukraine will make this choice.
On January 6, 2019, Ecumenical Patriarch Bartholomew handed over the Tomos of Autocephaly to Metropolitan Epiphanius. This document from Constantinople granted independence to the Orthodox Church of Ukraine. The Orthodox Church of Ukraine is now officially included in the diptych, the list of autocephalous churches. But the process of its recognition by the Orthodox world is still ongoing. In addition to the Ecumenical Patriarchate, the Church of Greece and the Greek Orthodox Church of Alexandria have started to establish full communion with the Orthodox Church of Ukraine.
We are now awaiting recognition from other Orthodox churches, Romanian, Bulgarian and Georgian. The Russian Church does not recognize our authority. We don't exist for them as a church. But we are certain that as soon as other churches recognize us, our neighbors will have to reckon with this and recognize our autocephalous status.
The Kiev Metropolitanate was founded in 988 after the Christianization of Kiev and Rus by Prince Volodymyr the Great. Before being annexed by the Russian Orthodox Church, it was under the jurisdiction of Constantinople. After receiving the Tomos of Autocephaly, Ukrainians became a stronger nation.
The fact that the Orthodox Church of Ukraine exists now means that it is equal with other Orthodox churches, such as Russian, Bulgarian, or Greek. On a spiritual level, Ukrainians know that they are a nation, since they received the Tomos of Autocephaly from the leader of the modern religious world.
Today, the Orthodox Church of Ukraine consists of 44 eparchies, 7,000 parishes, 77 monasteries, and 10 theological institutions of higher learning. Church services are conducted by more than 4,000 clergymen, including 62 bishops. Recorded by Olha Mikhailuk for UATV.